support by New York State United Teachers, working with parents and the community for our children's future. NYSET, a union of professionals, and by viewers like you.
All right, welcome to Homework Hotline. I'm Craig Zarambo.
And I'm Donna Minio. Homework Hotline is the place where you can get help with your homework on the phone, online, or on TV.
And here's how it works. Teachers from Dial-A-Teacher are standing by right now to take your call and help you with your homework.
If you would like help with your homework, call Dial-A-Teacher free at 1-888-986-2345.
You can also send us your questions on our website, homeworkhotline.org. Just click on the Yak Back button and send in your question.
All right, today is Wednesday, and that means it's time for our brain teaser. Okay, during the Civil War, this person had a calling to help others. At first, she started collecting and distributing supplies to the Union Army. She wasn't happy about not being able to take a bigger role on the front lines. She decided to become an independent nurse and care for wounded soldiers. She was given the nickname the Angel of the Battlefield for what she did. After the war, this person went to work for the War Department and helped reunite missing soldiers with their families. Later, while visiting Europe, this person worked on the relief organization called the International Red Cross.
When she returned home, she wanted to start an American branch of this organization. In 1881, the American Red Cross Society was founded. This person served as its first president. The Red Cross still exists today and gives care to those in need. It currently responds to 70,000 disasters a year, ranging from small house fires to large devastations like hurricanes. The program is also known for its military support, health and safety courses, and blood donations.
If you think you can solve the brain teaser, give our hotline a call at 1-866-264-5904 or just answer it on our website, homeworkhotline.org. Answer correctly and you could have a chance to share the answer at the end of the show.
Every correct response we added to our Hotline Hall of Fame. Earn enough points and you could win a tablet at the end of the season.
It's time to do some homework.
And we have some higher math we're doing
yes,
tonight.
Yes, we do.
Excellent.
Hi, who am I speaking to?
Arlenis,
I'm going to go to the board. I believe I wrote your problem down so we could get right into the math of this. But could you read it to me so I can double check?
Okay.
Thank you.
F of x is equal to 2x squared.
Okay.
Minus 3x plus 1.
Yep.
And g of x is equal to x plus 5.
Okay.
What is f of g of x?
All right, so it's a matter of a substitution problem, okay? What you see here is g of x in the middle, like this, okay? Mm-hmm. What you're gonna do is rewrite it as f and then put in what g of x equals. So you can put in x plus 5, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So now f stands for the function. Whatever is in that parentheses goes into every single x in our f of x, okay?
Uh-huh.
So now we have 2. We're going to plug in the x plus 5, and we're going to square that. Then we have minus 3 times the x plus 5, okay?
Uh-huh.
And then we have plus 1. So now, how do I square x plus 5? What would you do?
What was that?
What would you do to square x plus 5?
X plus 5 times x plus 5.
Okay, so I'm just going to write that out just so that anyone that's watching can understand what we're doing. And I'll put the 2 in the front, but we're not going to do anything with that 2 yet. So let's multiply this out. And what is x times x?
X squared.
Now I'm going to do the outsides. 5 times x?
5x.
Do the insides. 5 times x?
5x again.
Good. And the last 2 at 5 times 5?
25.
25. And we have that 2 still on the outside. What do I do when there's a number on the outside of parentheses?
Multiply it to each of the terms inside.
Okay, well, let me combine. I have 2 5X's in the middle here. I want to combine them. So what's 5X plus 5X?
10X.
10X, excellent. And plus 1. So now, let's multiply through. What's 2 times X squared?
2X squared.
And what's 2 times 10X?
20X.
Good. What's 2 times 25?
50.
Okay, now I'm going to multiply through by this negative 3. So what's negative 3 times X?
Negative 3X.
And what's negative 3 times positive 5?
Negative 15.
Negative 15 and a plus 1. Okay, so now we're going to put together anything that can be combined. I have a 2x squared, but no other x squared, so I'm just going to bring that one down. Mm-hmm. I have a 20x and a minus 3x. So what do you get there?
17x.
17x, excellent. And then I have, let's box it instead of circle, a plus 50, a minus 15, and a plus 1. So let's do the 50 minus 15 first.
Okay, that's 35.
35, and now add 1 to it.
36.
Plus 36. So that, all of that work gives us f of g of x. So our final answer is 2x squared plus 17x plus 36. I hope that really helped.
You really did.
Okay, good. Give us a call again. I love doing these problems with you.
I said, hey, hey.
Need help with your homework? Find the number for where you live and then make the call.
All right, that was an awesome problem. We have Josiah on the phone, and we're going to solve his problem now. Josiah, are you out there?
Yes.
All right, now we're working with a math problem tonight, yes?
Mm-hmm.
I'm going over to the board, and what kind of math problem are we working on, Josiah?
Word problem.
All right, what's your word problem?
There are 5 times as many strawberries in box A than box B.
All right.
There are 16 more strawberries in box A than box B. What is the total number of strawberries in both boxes?
All right. So I'm going to set up a table here, okay? And we have strawberries in box A and box B. Now, you said something specific about the number of strawberries in box A. What were those numbers that you said?
It said 5 times as many strawberries.
So 5 times the number of strawberries in box B, correct? And it also said something else. What was the other part there, Josiah?
There were 16 more strawberries in box A and box B.
And there were 16 more than the number of strawberries in box B as well. Okay, so that's really important stuff. Now, how are you guys working on this in school?
We didn't actually work on practice.
All right, so this is a little bit homework extra help kind of stuff, right? So we're going to try a guess and check then, okay?
Okay.
All right, so I'm going to plug in, let's say I pick the number 3 for the number of strawberries, and I'm going to draw a line straight across here. So this is my number. I'm going to say, okay, I think I have 3 strawberries in box B, okay? Now I'm going to take that number, and everywhere that I have over in A where there's a B, I'm going to put that number in, okay? So I'm going to take 5 times the number 3, the number of strawberries. And what's 5 times 3 equal?
15. 15.
That equals 15. Fantastic, Josiah. So now I'm going to do the same thing with the 16 because you said there are 16, also 16 more strawberries as B. So if I do 16 plus 3, what number is that, Josiah?
19.
Now, are these numbers the same? I can see that 15 and 19 are not the same, so number 3 can't be our correct answer. This is not going to work right there. It doesn't work, okay? So now we're going to go along. We're going to try another number, okay? Let's try number 4. So I put a number 4 here. Let me make my 4 without the zigzag in the beginning there, all right? And we're going to do the same thing, 4. So I'm going to come back up here, and I'm going to rewrite. So I have 5 times the number 4. We're going to go X times 4. And what's 5 times 4?
20.
All right, good. And now I'm going to plug it into the second part that you said where we had 16 more strawberries in box B. So I put 16 plus 4. And what is 16 plus 4?
20.
Excellent. So now I've just found out that B, the number of strawberries in here, has to be 4 strawberries, okay? And if I come over here and I plug in those into the number into this one, I get that I have 20 strawberries here as well. Okay, Josiah?
Yeah.
Fantastic. That was a really good problem. Call us again, okay?
Okay.
Thanks a lot. I
said, hey, hey. FOIL, an acronym for the rule for multiplying two binomials horizontally. First, outer, inner, vast.
We're going to need some whipped cream for all those strawberries.
Oh, yes.
All right, we're going to go back to the questions in just a minute. This year, Homework Hotline has teamed up with the Golisano Foundation to bring you a new series called Move to Include. Throughout this series, we'll be learning about different intellectual and physical disabilities, and more importantly, how we can include people with disabilities. In this series, we're going to talk with people and visit places that are doing just that. And tonight's Move to Include will visit Lutetia Doucette, a scientist at the University of Rochester. She'll explain what she does, how she got where she is today, and she'll talk about some of the challenges she is facing along the way. Check it out.
My name is Lutetia Andre Doucette, and I am a visiting scientist at the University of Rochester in the Warren Lab. And what we do here in the Warren Lab is we study genomics, which is studying the DNA and RNA of living creatures. I am a bioinformaticist. We use computer science in order to interpret biology from that perspective. So we have a lot of data that gets generated in the lab, and I help to interpret that data with computers. What we do here is study a model organism called Nasonia vitropennis. And this is a tiny little wasp that stings the pupa of a type of fly. And then that sting injects venom and the eggs into the pupa. We want to know, what is this venom doing? How is it acting upon the host? And can we then use that in order to create drugs to help other people? What I love about science is that there's so many questions to answer. It's kind of like having an infinite number of boxes. You don't know what's inside of them, but you try your best to open each one and to figure out what's inside. Every day there's a new challenge. Every day I'm learning something new. Every day I'm learning something new about myself. And that personal growth has been great as well. So just being able to explore and to know that I can solve a problem and I can make a difference in people's lives just by doing science. So there are a lot of myths about people with disabilities, and I think the biggest one is that we aren't capable. Even the word disable and handicap really means the inability to function. But just because your legs don't work, your hands don't work, or even if you're someone like myself who may have had a brain injury at one time, doesn't mean that you are incapable of functioning. It means you have to adapt. And at the end of the day, people with disabilities are people. We're human, and we come in a variety of flavors just like anyone else. And so, therefore, we are not bound by our disability. We are capable of achieving what we want to achieve, but we need a little bit of help along the way. Treat us like you would anyone else. And that goes a long way into creating that idea of community. We shouldn't be outside. We belong inside the fold with everyone else.
All right, this video was part of Homework Hotline's move to include. We really want to know what you think about tonight's video. Go to our website, homeworkhotline.org, and tell us what you think by clicking on the Move to Include survey button. And while you are there, check out our other Move to Include videos.
That was good.
Yeah, it was. Very good.
And she was just on set a couple weeks ago.
Yes, she was.
All right, we have Bethany from Brooklyn. She emailed us a question. I'm going to go work that work that for her on the board. All right, so Bethany emailed in a question where she has minus 2 1/3 plus a negative 2 3/10. And we're working with mixed numbers and different denominators. So right away, we got to take the mixed numbers and make them improper fraction. To do that, we take the denominator and we multiply by the whole number, and then we add the numerator. So 3 times a negative 2 is negative 6 plus 1 gives me a negative 7 all over 3. And then I'm going to add that to a negative, and we're going to do the same thing here. I multiply 10 times 2 gives me 20, and then I add 3 more, gives me 23, and it's a negative 23 all over 10. So,
Craig, we're dealing with multiplying negatives and then adding a positive, so you got to subtract the positive away.
Okay,
so it becomes 5/3.
So and 6 and 1 is still
negative 6.
Ah, okay, negative 6.
Negative 6 plus 1 is a negative 5.
Ah, okay, good. See, so here we're working together here, and this is good. So Donna's explaining that this is a negative 6 plus a positive 1 gives me a negative 5. And we're going to do the same thing here. We got a negative 20
and
plus a
3
gives us a
17.
Negative 17. Good call. Thank you very much, Donna. Excellent.
Okay.
So now we're going to work, and together we'll work this out. So I'll work this half and you can work that half. How's that sound? Okay.
Sounds okay.
All right. So I'm going to, we need a common denominator. What would that be, Donna?
30.
So I'm going to multiply this side by 10. I multiply both numerator and denominator. That gives me a negative 50 all over 30. And you've got a pen there and you can do that sign.
Okay. So then you get a negative 17 times 3 is 51 over 30.
Ah,
and
okay.
I switched it from plus and minus to just the minus because carrying
so
double
right
signs
away.
Is kind
gotcha,
of hard.
Gotcha. All right. So I'm good with that. And I hope our students out there understand what Donna was doing. All right, so now we're extending our page here. So now we got a minus 50 and we got a negative 51, and that's minus minus. So we're adding negative 50 and negative 51 is going to give us a minus 101 all over 30. So what do we got to do next, Donna?
I'm going to let you do the division.
All right, cool. So here we get the hard part
do
here,
the long
right?
division, yes.
All right, so like Donna says, and I'm going to do her trick here, we're going to take this piece here and I'm going to rotate. Can
it
I do that?
You got to
there.
It. Yeah.
There we go. We rotate like that. And then all I really have to do is I have to include my line across the top. So I'm going to redo that over here. I have 30 on the outside, and I have a negative 101 on the inside. So I'm going to go a little guess and check, and I'm going to go just based on 3. And I'm going to go 3 times 2 is giving me 60. That's going to leave me 60 minus 100, or 100 minus 60 is going to leave me a remainder of 40, too much. So I'm going to go guess of 3, and that's going to give me 90. That's going to be putting more in the ballpark. That's going to give me a 90 here when I subtract. I'm actually adding it because it's a positive number there. So that would give me 1 minus 0 is 1 and 10 minus 1, and that's becomes my new numerator. Now, because we have this in here, this has to be a negative number. So I have my answer as a negative 3 all over, or 11 all over
30.
All right, so we tag team this together, Donna. High five on that. It was a good job.
Nice job.
Thank you, Bethany. That was a very good question. Make sure you send us some more. Thanks a lot.
How do you know which century you live in? The 21st century is the 2000s. The 20th century is the 1900s. The 19th century is the 1800s. The 18th century is the 1700s. 17th century is the 1600s, so on.
All right, we had somebody call in
yes.
with a problem, but I need to go to the board so you can read it to me.
I can do that.
Okay.
All right, our caller, they didn't give us our name, but here's a call and we'd like to do it anyway. They have a red piece of paper, has a width of 4 centimeters. The length is twice the width.
So that's 2 times 4, okay.
We have a blue paper, has a width of 3 centimeters.
Okay.
And a length of 7.
Okay.
How much of the red will be showing when you put the blue on top in centimeters squared?
Okay. All right. What this is a problem on area, because you have a piece of paper, and if we could actually do the 3D here, you would move this and actually put it on top to see what was left showing around the outside. So first thing we're going to do is find this area. Well, 2 times 4 is 8. Remember, area is all this stuff. It's like an area rug, all the stuff inside. So we're going to do 8 times 4, which is 32. And that is centimeters squared. Is that the correct label, correct?
Centimeters on each side, yes.
Okay. And then on this other one, we got to find this area as well, which is 3 times 7, which is 21 centimeters, whoops, squared. So now what you're really going to try and do, and I'm going to just sort of try to draw this out. We have this big piece of red paper, and we're going to put on top of it a piece of blue paper. So all of this is covered by that blue paper. The question wants to know, what is this area equal to? Well, the best way to do that is to take the area of the bigger section, the 32, and subtract the area that's covered by both, 21. So 1 minus 2 is 1. 3 minus 2 is 1. So there would be 11 centimeters squared still showing on this paper. I hope that helped. Next time, leave us your name so we can actually call you and talk to you. Thank you. I said, hey,
hey. Need help with your homework? Find the number for where you live and then make the call.
All right, we have Jackson, our winner in tonight's Brain Teaser. Jackson, are you out there?
Yes.
All righty, so.
Who are we talking about?
Clara Barton.
All right, now, we gave a whole bunch of clues. What clue helped you figure out who it was?
Well, I mostly used when you said person in the Civil War, nurse, and the nickname, the Angel of the Battlefield.
So now, have you learned about Clara Barton in school?
Not really.
Not yet?
Not really. What grade are you in?
Eighth grade.
Okay.
Right.
Did you, during your research to figure out who Clara Barton was, did you find out anything we didn't tell you?
Not really.
No? Well, I know one thing.
What's that?
She was born on Christmas Day.
Was she really?
Yep.
All right.
So then maybe that's why she's so helpful.
So you want to do a shout out there, Jackson?
Okay.
Okay, who are you going to shout out to?
I'm not sure.
All right, so we're going to say Jackson's going to shout out to his mom, his dad, family members, his teachers.
Teachers, friends, there you go.
All right, cool. Congratulations, Jackson. Don't forget, every correct response goes into our Homework Hotline Hall of Fame. Earn enough points and you can win a tablet at the end of the season.
That's all the time we have for tonight. We're saying goodbye, but Dial-A-Teacher is available with free homework help on the phone until 7 tonight.
And tune in tomorrow for our Hotline Book Reviews. Good night.
Good night.
Tonight's Homework Hotline was presented as part of Move to Include, made possible with support from the Golisano Foundation. Learn how you can be more inclusive of people with disabilities. Log on to homeworkhotline.org. Click the Move to Include button.
Homework Hotline is supported in part by New York State United Teachers, working with parents and the community for our children's future. NYSET, a union of professionals, and by viewers like you.